In this video, I am going to dive into a solution that will save you time and effort when calculating the first and last working days, as well as the total number of working days in a month. Say goodbye to manual calculations and hello to efficient, accurate, and fast results with this exciting solution. Let's start directly in UiPath and see how to implement this function there. I have the following workflow, where I only define some variables. Let's check what does each one mean and for what it will be used. The first two variables, month and year, are to define the month and the year, for which I want to calculate the first and last working days, and also the total working days. The next two variables, start date and end date, are to define the start date and end date of the month. The next variable, all month days, is to store all days of the specific month. And the last three variables are to store the results, what I want to calculate in this workflow. Please make sure you are using the same data types, as I did here. I used only integer, date time and array of date time. These are all variables we need for this workflow. Let's start adding the different activities. First, I will assign a value for the month. For example, number 1, which means January. Then I will assign a value for the year. For example, 2023. This means, I want to calculate the values for January 2023. Now using these two variables, I will calculate the start date and end date. Let's start with the start date. As you know, the month always starts with 1, therefore I am using the year, month and the first day. This activity returns in this example the following value. It's the first day in January. Now I will calculate the end date. I mean, I want to calculate the last day of the month. As you know, we may have 30 or 31 days in a month. February has 28 or 29 days. So, to make the end date dynamic, I will use the following statement. In this way, I will get the correct date. In this example, I should get the following result. It's the 31 of January. Now we have the first day and last day of the given month. Using these two variables, I will calculate all days of the month and store them in this variable of type array date time. For that, I will write the following query. First, I will use range function to generate a sequence for all days of the month. This statement returns in this example the following sequence. It contains all numbers from 0 to 30. So, in sum, we get 31 numbers. After that, I will add each number to the start date. For example, for number 0, I will have the following statement. So, I will not add any days. This returns the following result. For the next number, I am adding 1 day. So the result will be the following date. For the next number, I am adding 2 days. So the result will be the following date. And so on, I will add days for the start date. At the end, I should have all days of the month in an array. Using this array, I can calculate the different variables later, what I want to calculate. Let's start with the first working day. For that, I will also write a LINQ query. First, I have to loop all days of the month. I already calculated the days and stored them in this variable. So, the variable D represents each day of the month. After that, I have to filter the days. I want to get all days of the month, except the days which are Saturday or Sunday. This can be done using this statement. After that, I will select each day, which meets the condition. This means, I will select all days of the month, except Saturdays and Sundays. After the brackets, I will use first function to get only the first day. In this way, I will get the first working day of the month, which is not Saturday or Sunday. To calculate the last working day, I can use exact the same query. So, I will write the same query again here. I only have to use last function instead of first function. In this way, I will get the last working day of the month. At the end, I will calculate the total working days of the month. For that, I can also use the same query. Here, I will only use count function. In this way, I will get the count of all selected days, which are working days. This is how to calculate the first, last, and total working days of a given month. I will print out the content of these variables so that you can see which result I will get. The first one is the content of the array variable, which contains all days of the month. Each day will be printed out in a new line. The next one is the first working day. I will print out the date a short date string. And also the day name, to check if the first working day is a Saturday or a Sunday. I will do also the same for the last working day. I will only change the names here. Here I will also get the date and the day name. And the last one I want to print out is the total working days. It's an integer number, which contains the count of the working days. So, it contains only the weekdays, but not the Saturdays and Sundays. The sequence is ready now. Let's execute it to check the result. The execution is finished. Let's check the output. As you see, I have first the dates of all days of the month January. These dates are the content of the array variable. After that I have the first working day, which is the 2nd of January, because the 1st of January is a Sunday. You can see here, that the day name is Monday. The next one is the last working day, which is also the last day in the month, because it's a Tuesday. And the last output is the total working days. So, in January we have 22 working days. Let's check another month, for example April. I will execute the process again. Here is the result. I have again all dates for the whole month. The first working day is the 3rd of April, because the 1st and 2nd are Saturday and Sunday. The last working day in April is 28, because 30 is a Sunday. And we have 20 working days in April. As you see, everything is okay and we got the correct dates as output. This is how to calculate the working days of a specific month using LINQ query. To make this sequence also better and to get exact the correct day, you have to check also the holidays. This means, you have to calculate the holidays and store them in an array for example. After that you can use this array to filter the working days, and to get the working days only. For that, you can either store the holidays manually, or you can use an API to get the holidays. Then you can use the holidays variable in the condition, to check if the day is Saturday or Sunday, and also to check if the day is a holiday. In this way you will get the correct result. Before ending this video, let me also show you some queries, what you can use to get a specific working day. I showed you how to get the first or last working day, but maybe you need to get for example the third working day in a month. For that you can use the following query. I only added skip function after the query, to skip the first two working days. In this way I will get the third working day as result. Or the following query, to get the first five working days. Here I use take function, to get the first five working days. Or the following query, to get the last three working days. Here I use take last function, to get the last three working days. And so on we can use different LINQ operators, to get specific working days. That's all about calculating the working days of a specific month.